Well, the blizzards of 2010 took their toll on the Baltimore area. In fact, the Sykesville fire station was partially destroyed because of the storms.
But now the first phase of a $5.5 million renovation is complete. 11 News reporter Kim Dacey got a tour.
Members of the Sykesville Fire Department are hard at work serving the people of the Freedom District of Carroll County. But during the blizzard of February 2010, they had to help themselves.
There was quite a bit of snow on the roof of the structure. The roof collapsed. In turn, major gas lines snapped. There was an ignition source somewhere, and we had fire.
Luckily, a firewall stopped the blaze from destroying the garage where they keep their trucks. But with no living quarters, the firefighters had to sleep in tents and then trailers. And through it all, never missed a call.
It was tough. It was tough because a lot of hard work went into the building that we had. I and a lot of other people put a lot of volunteer hours into the building.
Now, more than a year later, phase one of the reconstruction is complete, and firefighters and EMTs can enjoy a new lounge area and kitchen, individual sleeping rooms with beds, no more tents, and new and improved locker rooms and showers. The completion has lifted everyone's spirits.
I think now they finally see some progress being made, and I think everybody's looking forward to that first scoop of dirt or whatever for phase two.
That's right, they're not done yet. They plan to continue construction to make new classrooms, a big social hall, and more garage space to house new equipment. They're done looking back at what happened and are now looking forward to the future of the Sykesville Fire Department.
We'd worked hard. We'd paid off mortgages. Now we have another mortgage. And that means lots of fundraisers.
Insurance money paid for phase one. Now they're looking for donations to raise more than $4 million to complete phase two by 2012. For more information, you can visit our website, WBALTV.com. In Sykesville, Kim Dacey, WBAL-TV 11 News.